on College Road and the wall is leaking.
Edgecumbe, April last year.
The water is about 5 inches from the top.
This is 30 minutes before this happens.
Had a breach of the stop bank. It's proceeding with evacuations as quick as we can, over.
The residents had little warning.
If you are in Edgecumbe and you are listening to us now, watching us now, get out.
The entire town was evacuated, 300 homes damaged. A few days later, John Pullar got a call.
So Marty rang me.
Marty is Marty Greenfield, CEO, Whakatane District Council.
And we discussed the idea of trying to help these people get back in their homes.
So that was one of the houses there.
John is a retired builder, and Edgecumbe had a lot of people uninsured.
That house there might be insured, and all of a sudden you've got some derelict houses.
John had council on his side, but no funding.
If it was 70k a house, and they were thinking there was probably 100 houses, we were thinking, holy shit.
But John Pullar set up shop anyway, with Pearl from the council. They started offering help. It was called Livable Homes, and people were sceptical.
There was no fish hooks or catches. It was truly free.
One of John's first stops was Sherelle, who owns Peppers, the local building supply company.
People need their homes. That's the foundation to their lives.
Sherelle came in with materials. Other tradies worked for free or at cost. Rotary gave money, regional council too, and a trust from Gisborne.
So how much did you raise, Pullar?
It was $1 million.
It meant the unlucky, the uninsured, like Dave, had a home.
My kitchen's all new. I practically got a new house out of it.
Morning, Marion.
When Marion left, the water was up to her lazy boy. John organised for her house to be dried. Marion paid for her new kitchen.
I was in a predicament that I just didn't know where to turn.
Project Livable Homes has rebuilt 17 uninsured homes in 6 months. Mayor Tony Bond says even better, the ratepayers paid...
Nothing. The ratepayers didn't put into this. It was the community's donations.
John Pullar volunteered a year of his life so people with nothing have something.
A lot of people helped me over the years.
It means Dave, who lost his wife and then his house, considers himself lucky.
There's a lot of people much worse off than myself.
I guess luck is relative. Hayden Jones, One News.